In this video, you'll learn how to set up enhanced conversions for Google Ads. Enhanced conversions lets you send information your customers provide, like their email addresses, to Google Ads. This information is then used to improve the accuracy of conversions and even understand when customers use multiple devices before they convert. Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this tutorial, we're going to walk through two examples. We'll set up enhanced conversions for a lead form, and we'll also set up enhanced conversions for transactions. We'll be using my Squarespace demo site for both of these examples, but you can apply the same techniques to other website platforms too. Okay, let's head to my website. First, let's look at the lead form example. Let's navigate to the form. And let's complete the form. We can see there is a thank you message presented. In order to configure enhanced conversions, we need to send our customer's email address or their street address to Google Ads. Google recommends using email address, so that's what we're going to cover in this tutorial. We need these details to be available when the conversion occurs. We can see we're going to have an issue with this thank you page, as the email address we entered isn't available on the thank you page. So I'm capturing the email address when the successful form submission occurs using Google Tag Manager. Let's head to Google Tag Manager to take a quick look. Let's navigate to Tags. In this container, I'm using the Ajax Listener for Google Tag Manager by Marco. I'm using this because forms on Squarespace sites aren't tracked by the built-in form validation in Google Tag Manager. And just to highlight, I've already added a Google Ads conversion tag and a conversion linker tag. We'll come back and edit the conversion tag in a moment. Okay, now let's navigate to Triggers. We can see I've already created a trigger that will fire the Google Ads conversion tag when the form is submitted on the website. Now let's navigate to Variables. We can see there are a number of variables for the Ajax Listener solution. And scrolling down, we can see a user-defined variable that captures the email address from the form field when the form is submitted. The way you capture the email address for customers will depend on your website. You can use JavaScript to capture the value from the form field like I have, or ideally, you'd push the information to the data layer and create a data layer variable in Google Tag Manager. Now, to send email addresses to Google Ads, we need to create a new variable. So let's click New. Let's name the variable Google Ads Form User Provided Data. And let's select Variable Configuration. Now let's scroll down and choose user-provided data as the variable type. Now let's select the drop-down under email, and let's choose my email address variable. We're going to skip the other variables, but if you have this information, then you can pass this to Google Ads too. Now let's save the variable. And let's navigate back to Tags. Now let's select the Google Ads conversion tag for the form submission. And let's select Tag Configuration to edit the tag. Now we need to enable the option to include user-provided data from our website. And we can select the user-provided data variable we just created. Now we can save the tag. And let's click Preview. Enter the URL for our website and click Connect. Now let's navigate to the form. Enter our details and submit the form. Now let's select the Tag Assistant tab. And we can see the Google Ads conversion tag has fired. I'm going to select the data layer event that fired the tag. Let's select the tag and click Show More. We can see the email address is being sent to Google Ads for enhanced conversions. Now that we've covered how to pass the email address from a lead form to Google Ads for enhanced conversions, let's take a look at how we can pass the email address for a transaction. Let's start by looking at how we can capture the email address used for a transaction. To do this, let's head to Squarespace and let's select Settings, then Advanced, and let's choose Code Injection. If we scroll to the bottom, we can see the option to add code to the order confirmation page. And we can see I've already added a data layer to capture the basic transaction details. Let's modify this. Let's add customer_email and then enter the option to inject the email address into the data layer. This will mean we can use a variable to pass the email address to our Google Ads tag. Let's save this. And let's head to Google Tag Manager. Now let's navigate to Variables. And let's create a new variable. Let's name the variable Purchase Email. And let's select Data Layer Variable as the type. Now let's enter ecommerce.customer_email as the data layer variable name. And let's save the variable. Now let's create another variable. Let's name the variable Google Ads Form User Provided Data Transaction. Let's select User Provided Data as the variable type. Choose Manual Configuration and select the variable we just created for the email address. Let's save the variable. Next, we need to create a trigger, so let's navigate to Triggers. And let's create a new trigger. Let's name the trigger Purchase. Select Custom Event as the trigger type. And let's enter Purchase as the event name. Now let's save the trigger. Now let's navigate to Tags. And let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Ads Conversion Tracking Purchase. And let's select Google Ads Conversion Tracking as the tag type. Now we need to enter our conversion ID and our conversion label. For your tag, you will want to use variables to pass additional information about the transaction, including value, transaction ID, and currency to Google Ads. But for today, I just want to focus on enhanced conversions, so I'm going to skip these options. And let's enable Include User-Provided Data from your website. And let's select the new variable we just created. Now let's select Triggering, and let's select our Purchase Trigger. Now let's save our tag. And let's click Preview. We connect to our website, and let's navigate to the store. Let's add a product to the cart. And let's check out. Now let's enter our details. And complete the purchase. Now let's open the Tag Assistant tab. We can see our Google Ads conversion tag has fired. And selecting the tag, we can see the email address has been sent to Google Ads. When you're happy everything is working correctly, you can publish the changes in Google Tag Manager. And of course, if you're tracking transactions, you should take the time to send the other information to Google Ads, including the transaction value, ID, currency, and items. Are you going to implement enhanced conversions for Google Ads? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you haven't already, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel for all of my latest tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.